Okay, this is part four. Nope, daggone it, I forgot something. They traumatized my service dog. I am never apart from this dog since I've raised him and trained him since he was 3 months old. He's over 3 years old now. And he heard all the breaking of the glass. He heard the sirens, the people out there screaming at me. And, you know, he couldn't get to me. He couldn't help me. So he's in here barking his head off and wondering what the hell is going on outside. And all the bright flashing lights and everything to which he could see through the windows. Even though the blinds were shut, he could still see the lights flashing on the blinds. So then when, and I forgot the ending of the story, when they brought me home to officers, police officers, because they joined the chase too, folks. You know, there was three sheriff deputies, I was told, and two cops. So, you know, they're all together, okay? There's no damn difference between the sheriff's department and the damn cops, all right? They're all in the same freaking boat. And the boat is coming to you downstream, all right? So, anyway, when they brought me home, shoved up in the back of a SUV, which I think they literally, intentionally make them damn things so small, and I rode to the jail in an ambulance sitting in a gurney that they put up in there. First, they was going to take me to the hospital. I said, the hell you will. You're not taking me no damn hospital when they killed my daughter. They murdered my daughter. And this is the only hospital in this town. So anyhow, they took me to the jail. And long story short of that, when I got home, I only had a sweatshirt jacket-like thing on, no socks, tennis shoes, sweatpants, and a t-shirt. And it was freezing weather outside. I was dropped off. I said, well, hey, I don't even have my keys. I don't have my keys. How in the hell am I going to get in my house? Don't know, they said. I said, well, can you at least break out one of the window panes so I can get in my home? Nope, we can't do that. Now I thought to myself, nope, you can't do that, but you damn sure break out somebody's automobile's window, which, by the way, Ford Motor Company no longer makes. So I'm trying to find a salvage place to find a daggone window tinted, because mine are factory tinted, to fit my window. You know, I think it's bullshit that they break people's windows out. I think that ought to happen to every one of them. And run it up a pole or in a ditch or whatever. As y'all know, I do not like cops. And damn sure not the sheriff's department. No, I don't. And I don't make any qualms about it. But so they left me sit out there in the freezing weather at 10:30 at night. No one to call because they had my phone. I couldn't walk anywhere. I just had my walker. So they had to pry me out of the back of the unit, which the door was shoved into my knees because I cannot slide on a seat due to my spine's fragile condition. So I just barely had my knees in, and they had to pick my feet up to put them in. And the door shoved into my kneecaps and drove home like that, which was a long drive because that's all the way out East Highway, you know, from here, several miles. And so we get here to my home, and I had to pick my legs up, put them on the ground, get my walker out of their trunk, or the back end of the SUV, and one on each arm to stand me up, and then had to walk me to the sidewalk so I'd have level ground and firm ground to walk on. And my dog, he heard me, and he starts barking, and I let him know that Mama's home. You know, we hadn't been apart for more than, no longer than 3 hours. So he knew by the time it got to almost 5 hours that something was wrong. And unbeknownst to me, my granddaughter had my keys. She came by and had fed him and let him out, because he'd been locked up in the house all this time, you know? So when I, you know, had come here, I didn't know that she had been here, even though they all knew that I'd been in, you know, incarcerated, but I didn't know that she had let him out. So I'm thinking she's already gone back to her home at her town, and because she's a ways from me. And so I'm thinking, well, how in the hay am I going to get into my dog, take care of him, and feed him, and water him, and all this stuff? So I sat out there, huddled on my wheelchair ramp, and I had to pull my arms out of my jacket sleeves to put them in close to my body to stay warm. And I'm just sitting there for 45 minutes wondering whether I was going to die from exposure or what, you know. I couldn't walk anywhere to any of the neighbors, not that I would any of the neighbors, you know, but that was a long haul for me to try to get somewhere on a walker when my body's in the condition it's in. So that wasn't going to work. You know, I could have fell out there in the dark trying to even step down off the curb. I wasn't going to do that. So I was just sitting there. And then 45 minutes later, she shows up in the driveway. And then, of course, I lost it when she came up and hugged me. Because I couldn't lay down at the jail, you see. I had no way to support my back. I couldn't get down on the commode because my ankle does not bend. You know, I can't get it under me to bend. Some dodo on the net, when I told this story earlier, said ankles bend. I mean, are you serious? You have a joint there, dodo. Yeah, it bends up and it bends down. Hello. I mean, unless you're a robot and you're well, hey, even a robot moves its leg. But anyway, my right knee doesn't support me, so I can't get down and get back up on my right knee either. So I've got a 17.5-inch toilet disability commode in my home. I have electrical lift chair and other devices that help me live my life. And it's why I have my dog that does all. Picks up everything for me. He gets the clothes out of the dryer and hands them up to me. So he didn't eat for a day, and even now it's past a month since this incident. He won't let me out of his sight because he's scared that I would leave him again. Now, he's protected under the ADA, the Americans with Disabilities Act. To cause this dog harm or trauma is a felony. They have a lot of those coming at them. Because they not only tortured me, they tortured my dog. So there y'all have it. End of story. Well, at least to this point, it's the end of the story. But I guarantee you, there'll be more. Y'all be good. Take care. Detox. Carol.